Hi, my name is Steven Appiah, former international player. Keep watching Warm Up Plus on TV 3, 10 o'clock every Saturday.
Yo, I'm Kwame Kofi Kinata or Kodu Obisi will move. I say, Menchi, keep watching Warm Up Plus on TV 3. This and every Saturday morning. Move.
Hi, my name is Fifi Taki. Keep watching Warm Up Plus on TV 3 every Saturday from 10 a.m.
Yo, Jan Show. Keep watching Warm Up Plus every Saturday on TV 3, 10 a.m. sharp. It's your boy Atiko One. Fan them. Think of. Yes.
Hi, my name is Larry Kingston, former Black Stars player, and now Right to Dream U19's coach. Keep watching Warm Up Plus on TV 3, Saturday, 10 a.m. sharp.
My name is Nana Dakwajesi, commentator for the Ghana Premier League. Keep watching Warm Up Plus on TV 3 every Saturday morning.
Ye be piene akwa bonti akwa chinchin di sika be fie. Ye pe sika be fie. What's up people, this your boy Kwaku Darlington. Keep watching Warm Up Plus on every Saturday at 10 a.m. sharp on TV 3. Worry about grip pow.
Well, hello, good morning. You're welcome to Warm Up Plus right here on TV3. You know, every Saturday morning, we're on your TV sets, serving you sports, excitement, lifestyle, and many more right here on the show. My name is Yao Ofosulabi, together with
Aniela Alute. Now, Yao, week in, week out, GoFab in Tema has you covered with any clothing of your choice. You can reach them on the number 024-937-9052. The number again is 024-937-9052. Yao, this week, we're doing the basics in squatting. It's seemingly easy. Oh, just bend.
Yeah.
But you go see something.
But he had it.
He had rough. Let's take in guest 40. It's a beautiful Saturday morning, and it's time to get sporty on Warm Up Plus. I am Aniela Alute, and I'm currently at the Alisa Hotel Gym, joined by Mr. Emmanuel Kwe, my gym instructor. Today, we're going to be learning about the basics of squatting. But before then, we're doing a little warm-up on what Mr. Emmanuel Kwe calls the cross trainer. And he taught me two methods, going forward and also the reverse. So whichever one you feel more comfortable doing, it's pretty easy. Through with the warm-up on the cross trainer, and it's time to head over to the Smith machine for the basics of squatting with Emmanuel Kwe. Mr. Kwe, what exactly does it do?
This is a multi-purpose machine. You can use it for chest, squats, arms, and today we are going to do the squats.
So I get into position like this?
Yes. Okay. Make sure your legs are in line.
Wow, it's heavy.
Don't worry, I'll support you. So you go down. Slowly.
Am I holding it up?
Yeah. So push yourself back whilst you're going back. Whilst you're going down.
Okay.
Don't bend your knee. So go down. Squat. Push it back. See you're pushing your knee forward.
It's supposed to be pushed
back.
Yeah,
that's wrong squatting.
Wrong squatting is this way.
Yes.
So what's the correct way?
So you push yourself back. Make sure your knee and your toe be in line.
Knee and toe in line.
Yes. So you push yourself back as if you're sitting. Go. Nice, so.
Mr. Kwe, this looked actually easier when you were doing it.
Sure.
Yes, very much so.
Right, so yeah, welcome back right here on Warm Up Plus. And just going by, I was Get Sporty. Aniela was just taking you through the squats and everything. Gym instructor Emmanuel Kwe, quite experienced at the job, really. Aniela.
Kawawa, it's not easy. I mean, you see a lot of these athletes and football guys just doing the work, and you try, you attempt.
Yeah, and you sit here,
it's,
and you criticize.
It's not, no, you criticize. I'll keep quiet now.
Exactly.
Not a word from me.
Right, so that was good sporty just gone by. But today is another packed show. We are giving you a lot of excitement right here on the show. There's a big man in the studio this morning, and also a member from the Ghana Football Association and a sports journalist here who are going to be joining us for a discussion, a very lengthy discussion, before, you know, we get into the groove and everything to make you enjoy the show. But just before, you know, we get into all of that, we'll take a break. When we come back, Warm Up Plus will continue.
The thorny issue of...
We're back on Warm Up Plus, and it's time to delve right into the conversation. And I have two guests who are very up to the task. We have Julius Enuma, and he's the man in charge for safety and security for the Ghana Football Association, as well as Philip Sicho. He's my friend. I've had the pleasure of having conversations with him, and he's a commentator as well as a sports journalist in the building.
Almost certainly, Anila, that's it. Let's just get into the discussion now. But don't forget that on Tuesday, the 13th of July, is Three Sports Hooliganism Forum that will be held right here at TV3, the Executive Theatre. And we're just addressing what is happening across our football landscape. It's just pockets of violence here and there. We just want to find a lasting solution to this. So by that means, we have, you know, as Anela introduced, Julius is here from the Ghana Football Association, and it's a Three Sports and a GFA partnership, you know, to get this hooliganism forum done right here at TV2. You know, this place is where all the sports happens. We bring you just the best. Julius, you're welcome. Philip, you're welcome.
Thank you.
Julius, let me start
nice
with
to see you.
Hooliganism in Ghana.
Yeah.
What do you make of it?
Thank you very much. First of all, thanks for having me. This is a very important and a challenging aspect of our football ecosystem that requires a holistic approach.
Yeah.
And so when a stakeholder like a media organization of your nature is interested in addressing the issues, then we as a Ghana Football Association are very, very happy about that.
Yeah.
Now, you asked about hooliganism. Hooliganism is just a subset of the safety and security issues we have in the organization of football.
Okay.
And when I talk about safety and security issues, we are talking about crowd violence, we are talking about crowd disorders, mm-hmm. we're talking about overcapacity mm-hmm. and a whole lot of issues.
Right.
I mean, breach of access control and all of that. I mean, you remember even after the midnight when I think the Blasters played in a Super,
mm-hmm.
there was a gate break.
Okay.
I mean, and fans tried to stampede into the stadium. Four of them got injured and all of that. I mean, these are issues that are part of the whole framework of the challenges we are facing.
Right.
So hooliganism, which is, I mean, the aggression
mm-hmm.
and the attack mm-hmm. of either fans, officials, or away team
yeah.
in the frame of the game,
right.
is just a subset of the safety and security challenges that, as a Ghana Football Association, every organizer of football, I mean, has to come with.
Yeah.
Now, to speak on the position of the Ghana Football Association,
yep.
yes, we need to profile our problem. When it comes to hooliganism, like I mentioned, we have the ones that fans are rioting. For instance, if you go to Egypt, we had one of the biggest disasters in African football when Al Ahly and Amazu fans clashed, you understand.
Mm-hmm.
That does not normally happen in Ghana. They're having Kotoko and Hartlepool fans agreeing to fight at a place.
Yeah.
So we need to profile our challenge. What is our challenge? Coming to hooliganism. Our
mm-hmm.
challenge is that we have some group of fans who think that what they have to, what the best way for them to exert their displeasure of decisions, their displeasure of their team losing is to attack the away team or to attack the match officials.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to understand our peculiar situation as,
right.
as a country, then how to address it.
Okay.
Why are these things happening?
Yeah.
What are the causative agents? And we'll find a lasting solution to it. So I think it's holistic
mm-hmm.
because from the Ghana football perspective, through our disciplinary code, we have entrusted a lot of responsibilities to the home club to ensure that there is adequate security. And when we say adequate security, we are not just talking about writing a letter to the police that you need policemen to come and man your game. We are talking about putting together an operational plan. So from the Ghana Football Association's perspective now, we have trained club security officers for the Premier League.
Right.
Very soon, you are going to have a CAF training for these safety and security officers, because
right.
we believe that most of the problems that we have recorded is because of poor planning.
Okay.
And failing to plan is planning to fail.
Yes.
So if you have a big game and you don't know even the risk factor of the game,
yeah.
then you don't know where you are going as to safety and security.
Okay.
And for safety and security, it's all about anticipation.
Yeah.
And if you know that you are going to play a game between, let's say, Kotoko and Ashgood.
Let me, Julius, let me come in here. Now, I mean, from what you've said,
yeah,
you know, it's like, you know, the games that can cause some of these things. Mm. So, for example, I mean, BA United RTU, oh, you know, it was such a volatile game. Oh. It was a game that could spark violence.
Yeah.
What happened?
Thank you very much. And that's why I'm saying that we are profiling our issues.
Yeah.
That's a game that has gone to the adjudicating body, so I cannot go too deep on it.
Right.
But we've had similar ones, so okay, I can just yeah, I mean, speak to it generally.
Okay.
What we do is that, you know, in the past, we used to have the generic gradation of matches or categorization of matches.
Yeah.
We have the category A, B, C matches. Mm-hmm. A is only Hearts and Kotoko. B is Kotoko and Hearts against any of the other teams. And C is any of the other teams meeting. The Safety and Security Committee, when they took over, they have change the approach because we've realized that the dynamics to a game changes week after week.
Yeah.
So if, in as much as Elimina Sharks against Legon Cities is on any day a normal category C match, mm-hmm, we sit down, we look at the intelligence that we've picked, the risk factors that we are picking from the games,
mm-hmm,
the position of the teams, the stakes at hand.
Yeah.
So, and there are some of the games, it goes beyond football. It
right,
goes beyond football. It transcends to tribal, to politics and all of that.
Right.
So we look at all the stakes involved, mm-hmm, then we draw up a recategorization for these matches.
Right.
Now, when these recategorizations are made, it doesn't end there. There's a communication sent to the club. Like I mentioned, this responsibility is still in the home club. But we believe that as a GFA, we can't always be reactive.
Yeah.
Okay, fail and we'll punish you. No, because after the thing has happened, it's irreversible and it affects our image.
Julius, I mean, I know that, you know, you can, like, you know the issues and you can
yeah,
go on and on about it. But Tuesday is the forum,
yeah,
you know, which of which we're expecting that, you know, the FA shows up, coaches and other people will show up for a holistic discussion, as,
yeah,
as you've mentioned. But let's just bring Sicho into the conversation, Angela.
I mean, Sicho, I wonder about the mindset of some of the fans, because I don't think they particularly understand that this is also borderline crime. You are a commentator, you are a sports journalist, you have had the opportunity to be in games where some of these things happen. Do you think they do not know where to draw the line?
I think they do, but it's a general problem across the world. Fans are emotional because the sport's an emotional one. Between the time you feel you've been cheated or a decision is not in your favor and your reaction time normally is very short, if you don't process the thought, you could do something very silly before you understand what you've just done. I don't envy him. He's got a very difficult job. But the bottom line is that it's infrastructure issues. Fans are everywhere around the world. Like you said, sometimes the fans clash. It doesn't happen in Ghana. What we've recorded are fans breaching security, get access to the pitch, harass match officials and even players, and that is unthinkable. I personally think it's the reason why this season we've not had hooliganism issues at Accra Sports Stadium.
Right.
I mean, it won't happen because the facility is so good, it protects the actors.
Yeah.
So even when the referee has made a very bad call, you can be angry all you want, but you can't access the inner perimeter. I've been to venue, I'm lucky enough to travel around there. Match venue because I'm a commentator. I've been to venues and I just look at the place and I'm thinking this is not safe for football because it's still being under construction. It's not being completed. You find sometimes iron rod, you find the stones.
Yeah. The instruments that could easily be used.
Absolutely. You saw the stone, the pictures we saw on social media when they were clear. These things were not brought into the stadium, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't there, but I've had experience enough to know.
Yeah.
That when, go to Karl Randolph, it's not different.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's when it comes to our level of hooliganism, it's got to be infrastructure. I think that is the basic problem that we face. And like I said, I don't envy him.
Joe, I mean, many thanks. Julius, just in about a minute, what should fans, coaches, teams, everyone expect the forum that's going to happen over here on Tuesday? What should everybody, football actors, what should they expect? Just in 30 seconds.
Thank you very much. Yes. So like I mentioned, this thing mustn't continue.
Right.
That's one. Two, it is having an effect on our image.
Mm-hmm.
And also contributes to the lack of revenue because
right,
football now is an event.
Okay.
And at FIFA, at CAF, at even in all the international bodies, we are trying to see football as a service. So when Hearts and Kotoko were coming to play, I saw a lot of people who have lost taste for Hearts and Kotoko showing interest because in the past, they said, I'm scared. A minute could have happened again, you understand?
Yeah.
But now that is driving away, and that is where we want to get to.
Yeah.
People should be comfortable to assess the match centers and feel safe. That's most important. Not secured, but safe. first before secure. Yeah. So the forum is going to bring on board all the stakeholders.
Yep.
We are going to call on stakeholders to make big, big decisions, like you mentioned.
Right.
Government, the GFA, the Ghana Police, especially, we must make big decisions.
Right.
And what are these big decisions? We should improve upon our infrastructure. We should ensure that the police is doing the right thing, is doing what they have to do.
Yeah.
Let me cite one example if I have time.
Okay.
When Ghana Police South Africa,
yeah.
Awa Mohammed invaded a pitch, wanted to take a picture. He was not going to attack the referee or anything. What happened to him? He was arrested, he was put exactly. So we expect that the same thing. It is there already. The criminal law deals with it outside the confines of the GFA. Right. So we're calling on all the stakeholders. And this forum is going to address some of these things. Government should improve upon infrastructure
Julius,
at our facilities
thank
to
you. Thank
to
you
help
very
us.
Much, Julius. That's Julius Enuma there. Who's there?
I'm Julius Emuna.
Emuna. I'm sorry, Julius.
No, you are not the first person to get my name wrong.
Julius Emuna there. I mean, he's one of the... safety
officer
safety
and the club officer. Manager
okay at the Ghana Football Association there. He'll definitely be at the three sports forum to, that would you know three sports in partnership with the Ghana Football Association forum to address hooliganism right here on Tuesday the 13th of July. Now when we are back from this very short break, Stoneboy will join us on the stage and we'll have an exciting discussion right here on Warmer Plus. Don't go away.
We're back. Stoneboy is in the studio. It's a huge pleasure to finally meet the man himself. Now, Stoneboy, you've been traveling around promoting an Logger album. And I mean, I'm not a music critic and I don't need to be one to know that the album is fire. But let's just take us through the whole process of that.
Good morning, everybody. I think I'm still in bed, but... So pardon me if I'm all cladded up trying to cover my face. You know, as Ghanaians, sports and entertainment has actually kept us going. You know, I miss all the pressures that we all... You know, voice, add our voices to, we can't do without sports. It would be very frustrating without entertainment and sports. So, Ngoga Junction has been the latest body of works that I released in 2020, right in the heart of the pandemic. But it's done so well and actually was strategic in order to actually give people something to sway away from the whole news when you get up in the morning is how many people are dying, how many people are not. So it was very intentional to continue to release the album, even whilst you know we the world was dealing with a pandemic at that level. Now we see you know a drop in the numbers in some parts, and they say new variant, Delta variant, this and that. So many things just happening, but we give thanks that we're alive.
Yep.
And as well, it's not as I don't know, but I do not think COVID is as deadly as AIDS. To say that once you contact it, you know you're going to die. So we give thanks.
Yeah.
We're just keeping to the health requirement and keeping safe and all these things. And you know.
Yeah.
So.
But still, I mean, very very thoughtful of you to have thought about us, your fans, to give us something to get through the whole you know COVID period. But how were you getting through the COVID period yourself?
I was getting creative. You know, basically, I was getting creative. I'm always indoors anyway, so I took the opportunity to actually, you know, do some soul searching some more because you have some time to fix things and also reflect on the industry as a whole and the career path that we have chosen as entertainers and even as sports people because fans couldn't come out to the stadiums, we couldn't to the stadia, and we couldn't go to also play games and probably earn money in that. So I think the entertainment and the sports sectors were also heavily affected,
right.
Irrespective. So we're all managing, doing online football and online.
I mean, definitely, Stone, you have a lot of fans from all over the world, but it's like the love is concentrated in Ashaman. What was that like growing up in Ashaman for you?
Thank you. The reason being that somebody must be born from somewhere, you know, so I was born in Ashaiman, right. And that's where my roots are. Aside the fact that I'm a Voltairean, an Anglongan Alak Ble boy, to be precise. You know, so shout out to all of my people. Growing up in Ashaiman actually has made me the man that I am right now, and I'm grateful because I got the opportunity to grow amidst Dadaba, real hustler. There are all types of people. So you see, so I'm grateful. It's love. Thank you for my father for locating Ashaiman because you know.
I mean, definitely stored on your music itself. I mean, particularly Putu. I mean, you said that you stop writing, you go with the flow. Putu, I kept wondering, what exactly are you saying on there?
So that it's clear, I still write, but I think I've only graduated to add the skill of going from head, mouth, mic.
Okay.
You know, and then later head, mouth, mic, and then you write you it write. Down. Or sometimes you write it down and then you sing later, depending on what type of song you're working on and what kind of vibes, you know, come at that moment.
Yeah.
You know, so, but Putu was one of the miraculous songs that I ever did.
It sounds miraculous.
Bro, it's very miraculous. And today, let me say that it's one of my songs that appeal to the elderly community, and I'm surprised. So I think I spoke a language that the elders understood better than the younger ones.
I don't know if my mother understands it, but religiously, the woman keeps singing the song.
Which is right.
Yeah.
It blew off of the elderly fan base connecting to it and wondering what this guy is singing, also loving it.
Yeah.
So the creative process was like this. Street Beats had sent me some beats long time ago, and once again, I woke up at a point in time, I don't know whether it was morning or evening, I went to the office, you know, the office is where you record and everything. So I was listening to the beats, and I was like, this one today, trust me, what came to mind was so powerful that if you take a critical listen to the song, you find out that a phone was ringing in the beginning, but I couldn't. I was not going to answer that. Neither was I going to stop what I was doing at the time. So it recorded with the tone. So if you take a critical, if you listen carefully from the beginning, you hear a phone ring in the beginning. You know, so that's how spiritually inclined that song is. You know, so when I did the chorus, I was trying to do something really inspirational at the time, due to the times we were in, right? So I did pray go better.
Yeah,
and then I also laid this template. I laid down the vibes to replace with lyrics, but I couldn't find any lyrics.
Yeah,
but I also knew, you know, the chorus is supposed to be a summary of a song. So pray, go better. Inside of the song is prayers.
So it's a tongue. So I'll bring Stone into the conversation. But before I do that, Stone, I mean, football. Let's talk a bit about football. You played a little while.
Yeah. I loved football. I still love football. Mm-hmm. Not to say I loved football. Growing up in Ashaiman, you have to be able to. You'll be open to a lot of sports. Especially, I'm glad that we grew up around those times. We played the Kwetenge, the Chaskele, the football, the Sandown, the Tipon, many things.
Yeah. Chimpers, Anzama.
all of that. We played all of those. And Dikot, So I played football. I did all of those. I actually love football. My favorite position was striker and defense and wings. Not to say that put me in
striker, defense, and wings. Stone.
It depends on the match.
Yeah.
When I say this match, there's one guy, Steven. Yeah. Steven, he won the MTN.
Steven Sou.
Yeah, that man that played football with that man that we grew up together.
Right.
So you can imagine those are my, you know, so if, as he say, he did a game inside, then he go for front.
Yeah.
Then he will defend. But most of it, they play against me. I don't know why. So at the free tackle, I'm from the back. Yeah. But up until when, you know, the whole story, I couldn't play football anymore.
Yeah.
You know, and da-da-da. But I'm glad because my little brother is a baller. I'm saying it now on national TV. Somebody quotes me later.
Yeah.
That guy's going to do wonders.
Amazing. Sijo, let's bring you into the conversation. Now, Stone is an entertainer, you know, as he said, he loves football.
A footballer.
A footballer, an entertainer. You love football.
Defender, striker, winger.
Yes. Yes.
Depending on the match. Who is playing.
Yeah. Depending on the match and who I'm playing against. Coach, put me for correct place.
Right. So, Sitio, let's just look at the marriage between sports and entertainment in this country. As commentator for the Ghana Premier League, how do you think these two can help grow our football?
I actually think sports in itself, it's entertainment. The vibe, the feel, when you're watching football, it's not too different from when you see your star performing.
Okay.
Because the athletes are stars. True. And these musicians who bring in out these jams, Stone Boy's jams and all of that, they are your stars.
Yeah.
Now, when you put that together, that is super entertainment.
Wow.
You get it?
Yeah.
So it's why at some point in the season, we're looking at, what about bringing in artists to perform at halftime. Legon City's tried at some point.
Exactly.
Because it has a very good blend. Mm-hmm. There isn't a way you can love sports and not love music. In fact, one of the reasons why the UEFA Champions League in Europe did very well after the year 2000s was because of the anthem.
Exactly.
When the anthem got popular, people started vibing with it. Even the athletes themselves.
Yeah.
So music and sports, I think it's one thing.
Yeah.
I think it's one thing.
Yeah. Teacher, let's not even go far. The Accra has a folk theme song.
Yeah.
Arguably the best theme song.
Absolutely. Yeah. I think the Kotoko fans will be too happy. But even they would go back into their locker.
Except the way the woman pull up that verse, say, Kotoko.
I've had people say, I'm hard.
Stony
say,
if I read the vibe.
It means I'm neutral.
You know, but the truth of the matter is, we shouldn't be stuck in between. We have to normalize not sticking between when it comes to choosing the side you belong. Because I also, I had to gather vim. And only, I think, the last match that had to be, to just come and tweet and say, it'd be like we win the thing. And then some, but I had to add, but I said, say.
So when we come back, we'll find out which side you are on. We'll take a little breather here. When we come back, there's more on Warmer Plus. Zaga, give me the bang, give me the
hustle for the money, me work for the money. Larry, there, who's our DJ this morning. Larry, many thanks to you for joining us right here on Warmer Plus. But it's not just Larry; I'm thanking you as well for watching the show every time. We have Stonebo in the studio. Philip Sichopatrim is also a commentator in the Ghana Premier League, joining us this morning. But just before we were on the break, we're talking Ghana football and football as a whole. Tijo, let me come back to you. Tomorrow, and the lineup of games that we have in the Ghana Premier League, what are you expecting to see? Hearts of Oak, champions already?
Fireworks. I'm expecting to see fireworks because of the stakes. I think in the last 6 weeks, I've particularly gained interest in the bottom half of the table. Mm-hmm. The stakes seem to be a lot higher there than at the top. It got to Kotoko and Hearts. Now it's almost Hearts of Oak if they're able to get a job done against Liberty. Having said that, I think that they don't have to start playing the champagne football before the game is done.
Right.
Because they need to see that game out. They need to win.
Did they play that at Dwarfs?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
I think credit to Dwarfs more than Hearts of Oak dropping those 2 points.
Right.
Dwarfs really played well.
Okay.
And Boedu is demanding of his players. He wants somewhat perfection. Mm-hmm. And so I think he's going to be pushing down to the heads of the players.
Right.
They need to win.
Right.
However, the game that I'll be keeping an eye on more will be what is going to happen today between Dwarfs and Kinfessa and Techiman.
Right.
Both teams, Kinfessa on 37 points, Dwarfs on 38.
Yeah.
We know that the 40-point mark could be where your safety line is drawn.
Yeah.
So it's a crucial fixture for these sides. Mm-hmm. And it's one that they can't afford to lose.
Yeah.
It's one that they need to win.
Yeah.
Liberty are playing Hearts of Oak, like we said. They also need results coming their way. But they would also be, you know, in some confident mood going into the last round of fixtures where they'll be playing home against Kinfessa.
Right.
So this weekend promises a lot of exciting stuff.
Let me put you to the sword, Sitio. Who do you think will join Inter Allies out of the Ghana Premier League this season?
Ooh, it's a difficult one. I wish this show was the next week. So after this, weekend, so
everything will become much clearer.
I'm asking you because you've seen more games than any of us.
I have. Yeah. I have. But even so, it's a difficult one to pick. I tell you what. Okay, now because you're putting me to the sword, now I'll take it. I think. Liberty and Kinfessa might join.
Liberty and Kinfessa?
I think so.
I don't think Godfred Akotobafu will be happy with you, but
special access.
But soon, I mean, your club.
It's not my club. I don't own it.
You support it.
So
tomorrow you could be winning a first ever Ghana Premier League title in 10 years.
So that they don't crucify me. I think with some small research I did, Kotoko actually has won many things.
Yeah.
You know, Kotoko, champion for that one. Because that's for football there. NAC are grown FM, you know. You know, we have to normalize how people support, because definitely sometimes it's difficult for us all to come out openly to support and ginger the whole sport, because we are artists and we fear that maybe my diehard fan supports Kotoko. Once I say probably I'm gearing towards Heart of Oak, yeah, they might lose interest. But I want to use this blessed opportunity to ask people to normalize that this is not music. Music is different. As for music, it's feeling and it entails a bit more. This is sport. It's right there and then. If everybody supported Kotoko, how can we play a match? You know? So big up to everybody. Like I said, Accra House of Oak tomorrow, if we win now, it will be nice. By the way, they talk Accra House of Oak right now. House of Oak, give me coaching role. Yeah.
I'm sure Anela has a final question to you. But I mean, I heard from the grapevine that Reverend Eastwood Anaba loves you so much. He apparently calls you a professor of music because of your songs and the sort of things you say in your music. I mean, what goes into the thought of getting the notes together in a certain way, putting the words in addition to it? And how does that make you feel that a man of God of his pedigree sees you in that light?
Thank you. A man of God of his pedigree is actually a father to us all.
Right.
You know, so I don't want it to sound like he is part of that whole artist fan base type of vibes,
yeah,
where, you know, because he loves artist A, then he hates artist B, or he doesn't love one. I was honored when I found him through a comment on something he came across about me,
okay,
which found its way onto the pulpit.
Right.
I'm grateful because it threw more light on me from the Christian community,
right,
to also pay attention, and I'm very, very thankful for that. And actually, I put in some type of vibes into my songs where it's more of like it's a gospel. It can be termed as gospel song. I've had my songs being played in churches and all of that, which is what I want to do with my song. I'm a musician. I don't want to put caps on my creativity,
yeah,
or what I speak about. I can speak about God. I can speak about, because in the end, we are not devils. Or we are not Lucifer, you know? Just because sometimes we look scary. You know, a man must be scary, you know? Yeah.
I mean, definitely, Stone. Before I ask my last question, I just want to say that I relate to your music. Sometimes I listen to it and I think that I'm also selling on the roadside.
Right.
I'm also doing, I feel the passion. Right. I feel, hey, come on. I mean, definitely, but you've given a lot of yourself to music.
Truth.
Would you say that it has been kind to you?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm grateful for how far music has brought me. Music has given me a mouth to speak. Music has given me a job to do. Music has actually given me a position in society where I pray to continue to use this innate to add to the voices that can make a change or better people's lives, like I've always tried to, you know, or I've always done, and myself as well. So I'm thankful to the spirit of music, you know, and for choosing me. I couldn't have chosen.
Right. So, Joe, a final question to you. I mean, how would you sum up this Ghana Premier League season in entirety, from all you've seen, briefly?
One word for it would be brilliant.
Okay.
For me, because, listen, everybody's talking about it. If you go back to the Super Clash, look at the celebrities who were tweeting about it, the politicians, everybody was part of it. When you look at attendance, even though there's COVID, mm-hmm, the 25% that if allowed,
yeah,
has been massive.
Yeah.
And the fact that the Olympics are performing well, Heart of Oak, Kotoko, and what have you, has been brilliant to see. And I'm looking forward to what would be another exciting season for the next one that is to come.
Italy, England.
Narrow win for Italy, in my opinion.
Brazil, Argentina.
It's going to stay in Brazil.
Stone, Brazil, mm-hmm, Argentina, who's winning?
Brazil, they be crazy. Brazil, they go free match of
England, Italy.
Another
hard one, eh?
Yeah, me, I go choose based on some kind of feeling. Italiano. Oh, yeah, but hold on. I'm saying Italiano, you know me, say, I say, take time. I say, no,
so you don't choose Italiano? I don't want to make my England people.
Thanks, Brazil.
Okay, I go choose who win. in the end, I go support who win.
You go support who win.
Yeah.
Okay. Fair enough. Thank you so much, teacher, for joining us here on Warm Up Plus. It's always insightful to hear from you. Stone.
Yes, madam.
Charlie, nobody knows tomorrow.
Oh, before make her say something, as I enter here, she say, if you sing that song, one line for me. So I know, say me the car. I say, hustling from Choco to Mamprobi. From a shaman to Kotobabi, with a burn under the sun, but still give Jaja the glory. Oh, yeah. Sometimes he be dog change, not the carry. Meat by rap.
At the rush, at the hurry. Dada baffle where he be like, say, Kaya, yo, I go marry. Anyway.
With him be my own. I'm not in this alone. Because right. Somebody
need a sweat for the air condition. He be lonely, in the home.
Stone. I mean, we can't let you go without, you know, promoting your social media handles, yeah, yourself, and you saying something to your fans before you just
God
give
bless you, everybody who's tuning right now, and I'm sure we made you smile at least for tuning in, all our fans from across all walks of life. Sports and entertainment is key, and so we urge the government to take a critical look, especially at the entertainment side.
Yeah.
You know, because the sports, they collect some food. We need some food and the thing. I mean, you know? And let's all go out there and support our teams. I've been very happy to see the Ghana Premier League get on the levels it's on, filled stadiums and all of that. We're happy. And before I leave, I pray everybody keeps calm and be successful in life. Take it easy. Life is a journey. You know, all the fingers are not equal. Identify your role, know your gift, and you will be happy in life, you know? Great.
I mean, most definitely. Thank you so much, Stone. Thank you so much, Itio, for joining us today on Warm Up Plus. Join Yao and I same time next week at 10 a.m. But before we go, Stone Boy, you and music inseparable. So, right, you forgive me.
Hey, this one, I'll be full attitude. So, I'll be performing today. But Juliet, you yourself, you know, 10 billion. Yeah. TV3, 90 billion. All me can do. All right, what you see. So, which one we going to do right now with that?
Oh, which?
Ah! Yeah! Ah, no problem. Show them your dance. We'll make we see you today. Ajay. Ah! Remix! You know, hey, say, you ready? Check! Hey, what's up? Who's in my car? You ready? And yet, we're your friends, TNU. Yes, you don't hear the French. Say my baby, whoosh. All of my mommy people, Ajay, big up for the self. Pull it up. Thank you very much. I'm grateful. It's a nice Saturday. I love you all. See you guys when I see you guys. Bless. We have a party.